Rice is a food staple for more than 3.5 billion people around the world, particularly in Asia, Latin America and parts of Africa. But after India's rice crop falters, world food supply faces a new threat. Rice could emerge as the next challenge for global food supply, as the shortage of rain in parts of India has caused planting area to shrink to the smallest in about 3 years. The threat to India's rice production comes at a time when countries are grappling with soaring food costs and rampant inflation. India's total rice planted area has declined 13%. Thus, in a bid to control domestic prices, the Indian government banned exports of broken rice and slapped a 20% export tax on several varieties of rice starting September 9th. India accounts for approximately 40% of global rice shipment, exporting to more than 150 countries. The impact of rice export ban by India would be felt both directly by the countries that import rice from India and by all rice importers because of its impact on global rice rates. Now see, India has been the world's largest rice exporter in the last decade. The export earnings stood alone at $8.8 billion in the last fiscal year. So the export ban will not just cause internal disturbance in India, but also international. But this export ban was rather a more needful move than a political one. Why? Let's understand the maths behind India's rice export ban. Indian government banned the export of 100% broken rice, which is predominantly used as cattle feed, and imposed a 20% export duty on several other grades of rice like parboiled or basmati rice. Researchers say that the production of rice in India is constrained by both droughts and heavy rainfalls, which can flood the fields. To understand this, it is important for you to know that about 68% of total cropping area in India is rain-fed. Of the roughly 40 million hectares of rice harvested area in India, 60% is irrigated, leaving the rest dependent upon rainfall and hence prone to rot. Even if the farmers sought to methods other than rainfall for irrigation, a normal rice field on an average requires 15,000 liters of water to produce 1 kg of paddy. Traditional farming needs 3,000 to 5,000 liters of water to produce a kilo of rice. So it directly means that if there is no rainfall, then it is unsustainable for any country to cultivate rice. Rice is a water-guzzling crop. Its cultivation alone is causing major decline in the groundwater. That is a threat to availability of water for human consumption. To save this water diversification, government is advising to plant less water requiring crop. In India, it is grown majorly in West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Assam, Tamil Nadu and Haryana. But recently, due to unprecedented monsoon in the country, has pushed many states to restrict farmers from producing rice. For example, recently the farmers from Haryana are been protesting against the state government under which farmers have to diversify at least 50% of their last year cultivated paddy area by growing alternative crops. The restriction of cultivation is under the state government's crop diversification scheme Mera Pani Meri Virasat for replacement of paddy by alternative crops in 1 lakh hectare. So the government is urging farmers to grow maize, millets and pulses as a paddy replacement. Haryana government is even offering Rs 7000 per acre to farmers, shifting the paddy fields to other alternative crops. Similarly, the Chhattisgarh government has been attempting to encourage farmers to opt for crops other than paddy. For this, they have been offered an input subsidy of Rs 10,000 per acre. Other states are also looking for methods to reduce paddy cultivation. So where does this blame fall? Rainfall. Monsoon in India has undergone several changes over the years, especially on account of climate change. A shift in the track of monsoon system is the byproduct of human activities driven climate change. Extremely heavy rainfall events over the last two monsoon periods may have led to the perception that the India summer monsoon rainfall has increased, but in fact, it has actually decreased by 6% over the last 60 years. Even a 0.5 degree centigrade increase in warming would imply increased perception of 3%. You must know that around $3 trillion agriculture dependent economy of India depends entirely on monsoon. So climate change isn't just affecting us from afar, but it has been hitting us quite closely. Climate change driven changes are pushing countries into irreversible crisis, not just economically, but also personally. Intense monsoon is just one factor when in reality the outcome we are about to face can wipe life on earth once and for all.